A tree is an amazing data structure. Each node can have any number of children. However, the most commonly used tree data structure is a binary tree, where each node can only have two children. That is why the term binary, right? And then we have a more specific case, that is the binary search tree, where the left node is smaller than the parent node and the right node is larger than the parent node. So when it comes to problems that involve a binary search tree, this property becomes vitally important and you have to use it. Today, we will be exploring a problem, range search of binary search tree on LeetCode, and we will try to use this property. Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, a place where we explore the life of technology and make programming fun and easy to learn. First, I will explain you the problem statement and we will look at some sample test cases. Next, we will look at the most straightforward way that you can approach this problem. And then we will try to optimize it. After that, we will also do a dry run of the code so that you understand how all of this works and it stays in your mind forever. So, without further ado, let's get started. First of all, let us try to make sure that we are understanding the problem statement correctly. You are given a binary search tree and you are given a range low and high. What you need to do is, you need to find the sum of all the elements that fall in this range. So let us try to relate this problem with one of our test cases. This is our binary search tree and these are the two range, right? 4 and 15. What we need to do is, we have to find the sum of all the elements in this tree that are between in this range. So when you will look at this tree, what do you see? You see the element 5 is between 4 and 15, 7 is between 4 and 15, 10 is in the range, and 15 is also in the range, because the problem says that this range is inclusive. So if you will find a 4 in the tree, then also you have to include it. So once you have found out all these elements, you simply need to add them and then you just have to print the sum. So the total is 37. And for this test case, 37 would be your answer. Similarly, we can look at a different test case also. Test case number 2. This time our tree is pretty large, right? And you have the range 6 and 19. Once again, what you need to do is, you need to find out all the elements that are inclusive of this range. So if you look at this tree, 6 is inclusive, 7 is in the range, 5 is not in the range, then you have 10, 15 and 18. So to get the answer to this test case, what I will do is, I will simply add up all these elements. And when I sum them, I get the answer 56. And for this case, this will be your answer. For now, if you have understood the problem statement correctly, feel free to try it out on your own. Otherwise, let us look at some solutions to solve this. Okay, so let's say I have this test case in front of me. I have this binary search tree and these are the two ranges that I have to find the sum. When you start to think about the solution, what is the first thing that comes to your mind? The most standard way. What you could do is, you could traverse through this entire tree and look at all the elements. When you think about traversing trees, there are three standard techniques, right? The in-order traversal, the pre-order traversal, and the post-order traversal. And the advantage of these traversals is that it will iterate through each element of the binary tree, right? And once you're iterating through them, just check if each element is in the range 6 to 19. If yes, add it to the sum and move ahead. Otherwise, just skip it. So when we would be doing an in-order traversal, what you would do? You would traverse through 10, then 5, then 3, then 6, then 7, then 15, and then 18. And once you are done traversing, you will know specifically which of the elements lie in this range. If you want to know more about in-order traversals, check the link in the description below. So getting back to the problem, when you will be doing an in-order traversal, you would see that 10 lies in the range, 7 is in the range, 6 is in the range, 15 is in the range, and 18 is in the range, right? So what I will simply do is I will start adding each of these elements as I traverse through them. And once your traversal is complete, you can simply add them up and this will give you your answer. Now, this approach works and it is very correct. It will give you a correct answer every time. But do you notice an important thing over here? We never took any advantage of the fact that this tree is a binary search tree. A binary search tree means that the left portion will have all smaller elements than 10, right? And the right subtree will have all the elements greater than 10. We are never utilizing this property anywhere. So it means that there is a solution out there which is more efficient than this. So let us take a look at it now. Okay, so how do you take advantage of the fact that this is a binary search tree? Let us take up the same sample test once again, and we have the same range 6 to 19. What we just did is, we did an in-order traversal to explore the entire tree, right? And just to rewind a little back, how does an in-order traversal work? Suppose you have this tree, then the in-order traversal would be A plus and B. What does that mean? You explore the left subtree, then you read the root, and then you explore the right subtree. That is how an in-order traversal works, right? So what you can do over here is, when you are exploring the left tree, then always make sure that the root lies in that range that you are exploring. Think about it. If the value of the root that you're reading is even lesser than the lower limit, 6, then all the values in the left subtree will be smaller, right? So you do not need to explore that. Similarly, if the value of the root is higher than your high limit, then all the values to the right of that node will also be greater, right? So why do you even need to explore that tree? So what you can do is, only explore the left subtree if the value of the root lies in this range. Only then you will find some elements, right? If the value of root is lesser than low, then simply skip out the left part. You will not find any elements over here. Then you can read the root. And then when you are exploring the right subtree, make sure that the value of the root is in between this range. Only then you will find some elements over there. What does this mean? Let us say the value of low is 11. Then you have to find elements between 11 and 19, right? So first of all, what you do is you check if this value of the root node lies in the range 11 to 19. It does not, right? 10 is even lesser than 11. So you can simply say that all of these values will be trimmed out. You do not need to explore the left subtree at all. Your problem statement only reduces to exploring the elements in the right subtree. So this way, you can reduce the time taken by your program. You can increase your speed, correct? And this is how we were able to take advantage of the fact that this is a binary search tree. Now, let us quickly do a dry run of the code to see how it actually works in action. On the left side of your screen, you have the actual code to implement this solution. And on the right, I have a sample test case. Now, this root is passed in as an input parameter to the function along with the limits low and high, right? Oh, and by the way, this complete code and its test cases are available in my GitHub profile as well. You can find the link in the description below. So, moving ahead with our dry run, what is the first thing that we do? First of all, we have a terminating condition, that is, if root equals to null, just return 0. That means you didn't find any tree, right? So simply return 0. This is also a terminating condition. Next, what we do is we initialize the value of sum to 0. That means if we have a tree ahead, simply initialize the value to 0. Then we will add on more elements if required, right? Now comes the crucial part. Explore the left subtree only if the value of root is greater than the lower limit. Right? So that means you should only explore this tree if the value of root is between 6 and 15. That is what we talked about, right? So right now, 10 is between 6 and 15. So that means we can find some values in the left subtree, right? So what we do is we call this function again recursively with the left node as my root node. So this time this tree will be passed in as an input parameter along with the same range low and high. What happens? This loop executes again. We are not at a terminating condition. The sum is again 0. And we again encounter the condition explore the left subtree. This time check the value of root. This is 5, right? And it is even smaller than the lower limit. So what we can simply do is we can discard all the left part of this sample tree, right? So you see how we were able to effectively leave out a portion. Right now this tree is very small, so you don't see it. But if this tree was larger, then we are simply getting rid of all of this part, right? And hence an efficient solution. Now simply move ahead. Next, what you do is you check if the value of root is between your range. Right now 5 is not in the range, right? So you don't add this value. Go ahead, and what we'll do is follow the in-order traversal and explore the right subtree. When you're exploring the right subtree, you will explore this part. So 7 is in the range, right? So we will explore this. When this loop will run again, we will add this value to my sum because it lies in the range, right? So what will happen is 7 will get added to this sum. Since this is a recursive loop, it will go back to the original value 10 and try to explore the right subtree. But at the same time, since 10 lies in the range, we will add 10 over here. And then ultimately, we will add 15 when the traversal completes. So when this function ends, you will get your answer 32 in your sum variable. And this is the answer. The time complexity of this solution is order of n. That is because it could be possible that all the elements lie in your range. And the space complexity of this solution is also order of n. That is because we are maintaining a recursive stack of all the elements that are present in your tree. I hope I was able to simplify the problem and its solution for you. As per my final thoughts, I just want to say that whenever you see problems involving binary search tree, always try to take advantage of the fact that the left node is smaller than the parent node and the right node is larger than the parent node. That is because based upon certain conditions, you can simply trim out portions of the tree, right? If you do not have to explore the larger values, you can just get rid of all the values. And that means you will spend less time traversing the tree. When you are spending less time traversing the tree, that means you are speeding up your program, right? And this will always give you a better time complexity. What other problems did you see where you were able to apply this concept? What problems did you face? Tell me everything in the comment section below and I would love to discuss all of them with you. You would be also glad to know that a text-based explanation to this problem is available on the website studyalgorithms.com, a pretty handy website to help you out with your programming needs. I'm including a link in the description below in case you want to check it out. As a reminder, if you found this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends. This motivates me to make more and more such videos where I can simplify programming for you. Also, let me know what problem do you want me to solve next, or rather, what do you want to learn next? I'll be glad to help you out. Until then, see ya!